Have you met those people that hate on everybody and everything? Recently, I was looking on the internet for a piece of information, and up came a link to a website that, when I got there, was extremely negative. And it was the entire premise of the website was there to bash a particular company. And as I started to read through some of the posts that were there, I became very aware that what they were claiming was that this particular company, in it everyone is bad because everyone takes your money, causes huge problems for you and your family, and that you should never deal with this company ever again. And they're everywhere. They advertise with Google AdWords, they post on other people's websites. It's an extremely virulent website. And as an aside, I have been reading a book called E-Myth Mastery. And in it, Michael Gerber talks about a time in his life, in his business, when he had relinquished control of the finances to somebody that he trusted. I think it was his partner or an accountant or something like that. And he had nothing to do with it. He was not aware of anything going on. And the problem that it created for him was financially devastating, because he ended up owing a lot of money that probably, had he been more aware and sort of kept his fingers in that pie and just was sort of keeping track of what was going on, that he would not have incurred those problems, or would not have, those problems would not have developed. And it got me starting to think about money and small business people. And in our school system, it's very rare that they teach the kids anything about money, about credit, and how to deal with your finances. You're educated on all these other things that in a lot of cases you really don't use once you get out of high school. And this is one of the areas where we really do need to educate our kids. I remember when I got a credit card when I was younger, I went, oh my God, this is so cool. You give them this, they give you whatever it is you want. Never ever dawned on me how long it would take to pay off some of that stuff based on the very low wages I was making. And so getting back to this bashing of companies, I don't believe that, or rather, I like to believe that people are intelligent. And conversely, I don't believe that they're stupid. And if they are permitting someone to tell them what to do with their business, because in any multi-level or direct sales organization, you have a choice. You have a choice on whether you buy inventory, how much you spend, and how you work your business. It is your business. And so to me, it's really quite amazing that these people who are bashing are saying that the people that get into this these companies and, quote, are taken for a ride, or their money is sucked out of their life because of this particular company. I think that's false. Because these people, if they are intelligent people, have a choice. And I remember I love to bring people into our company because I know it works. I know that when I work, when I sell something for $2, I've made a dollar profit. So you cannot buy something for a dollar, sell it for two, and not make money, unless you're not budgeting properly, or unless you're embezzling the money that is designed to go back in to replace your inventory. So I think it's really important to look at where these people are coming from. One of the women years ago that I brought in, and she didn't stay very long because I could not get through to her. You do not need to buy certain things before you have a profit level. When you start out, there is an expense. Granted, there is an expense to getting started in any business. And with a small business like Mary Kay or like any of the others, it's a small expense compared to what you might put out if you were opening a McDonald's franchise or something like that. However, this woman decided that she needed all sorts of display material, things that probably were totally unnecessary for her even in the first 2 years of her business. And it didn't matter what I said to her, that was what was important to her. She never went out and held a skincare class. She didn't develop customers, so she wasn't making any money. So very likely she could have come back, except that I did not encourage her to buy inventory when I know that she wasn't selling. She could have said this business didn't work. However, if you really look at it, it wasn't the business that didn't work, it was her. She never ever got past the stage of dreaming of having a business and playing with it. She never actually did the work. So I think when you hear people bashing other companies or other people, I think it's really a good question to ask, what exactly did you do as far as the work aspect of your business? Like, did you hold appointments? Did you attend sales meetings where you get your training? What did you set a vision for your business or plan anything? Or was it fly by the seat of your pants, order all the stuff because someone told you to, and it was not a decision that you made intelligently? And that is the key right there. We're big people. We're adults. We know what we can afford and what we can't afford. And to say that someone forced you to order a certain amount of product is giving your power away. It's not giving yourself the credit for being an intelligent person. If you made an inventory decision and then failed to work the business, that's your problem. That's not something that someone else did to you, because any business that opens orders inventory. You will not see a dress store out there that has empty racks and then expects you to shop in their store and they say to you, well, we'll get it in 2 weeks. So I guess my sort of rant for the day is based on, you know, it's equivalent to saying the gym didn't work for me, and I did a post on that. The gym didn't work for you, or you didn't work. Because we all know that if you go out and you put in the effort, whether it's business, whether it's fitness, you will get results if you do the work. Anyway, have a fabulous day, and look forward to talking to you soon.